I don't know if I said this already, but basically the series is all over the place, as per usual, but yeah. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 43 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today is the first installment of my mini-series that I'm going to do titled My 2019 Makeup Favorites. Because I have so much, I have split it into 4 parts. So, just so you know, today is part 1 and that is cream-based products. Yes. Yay me. This is my cream-based products, so primers and foundation and concealer. Yes, is the concealer there? Yes. Then the second one will be my powders. Basically face powders, including bronzers, highlights and blushes, blush toppers, that kind of thing. Then we have eyes and lips. And then we have eyeshadow palettes. Without further ado, let's get into the primers. And let's start with my absolute favorite. And it is so sad because I am almost out. And that is my Fenty Pro Filter Instant Retouch Primer. And it is, I broke it open so I could scrape out the last. I don't know if you can see it, but there's a tiny bit left. And what I use to scrape it out is a silicone thingy. That's how I use it. It is almost out. It was my favorite. It is actually the primer that got me started on cream primers again. It's so good, but it's pretty expensive. So, yeah, but it is, it kind of does it all. It mattifies, it grips my makeup, the foundation that I want to put on top. It evens out, it hydrates. It's just a very, very good product. And maybe instead of trying out 10 different ones trying to dupe this, I should just have repurchased the full size. But yeah, it is also a little bit difficult for me to spend that amount of money on a product like this. But it is my all-time favorite as this year. Yeah. Let's go then next to a few drugstore options if you don't want to spend the money. I do have to say there is none as good as the Fenty. Just saying. One that comes close, yeah, is the Revolution Pro Hydra Matte. It kind of makes your face feel a little bit softer. It does mattify, it does hydrate. It doesn't grip my makeup as well as the Fenty one does. But if it is a little bit dry down, at first you feel silky and then I have it on my hand so I can kind of feel it. And then it tends to grip a little bit. So it's a very nice product and one of my favorite drugstore options. So yeah. The next one that I kind of want if the weather maybe is a little bit more sweaty, I don't know. I need a little bit, I have days that I need a little bit more grip on my face. Then I grab this one, which is the Catrice HD Active. Focus, please. I have it on my face today, actually. And this is with a dropper. It is pretty thin, so the Fenty one feels like a moisturizer consistency. The Revolution one is a little bit thinner, and this is the thinnest of all. It feels a little bit weird when you put it on, but it has a nice grip to it. It is lightweight because it is so thin, so I really liked this one in summer when it was really warm outside. I really like this one. And then, do they make my makeup last longer? I have no freaking idea. I just like them, and they help keep my makeup here, which is what I want. The last one that I have, if I want a little bit of a nice glow, but not shiny, glittery, illuminating stuff. That's this one from Catrice. It is the Tensational 10-in-1 Primer. I actually really, really like this. This is, I will show you this one. This has a tiny bit of a sheen. So no, not really glittery, but a tiny bit of a sheen. And I like this, especially underneath more mattifying foundations. I don't know, it is just pretty. It's a very pretty primer. So yeah, it smells, that's not nice, but yeah, it has kind of a floral scent that does dissipate. But yeah, if I want an illuminating primer, this is the one I grab because I think it's really pretty. I don't like that overly glitteriness because I want to be able to glittery myself. And the product I use for that, it's weird English, I'm going to mention in tomorrow's video or the next video in this installment. I need to say that. Okay, let's then kind of transition between my primer, my face primer and my foundation. And I transition with this one. This is the Catrice 1 Minute Face Perfector. This is a mousse. You can use this on its own instead of, for instance, a BB or a CC cream because it evens out the skin tone. And it mattifies a bit, but it also makes your face feel nice and silky. What I like to do with this on days, especially in summer, when I slather myself with sunscreen and I don't want foundation on my face, that is when I use this every single time, actually, because it removes that excess shine. It evens out my skin tone a bit and it just feels nice. It just makes my face look nice. I like to apply this with a brush. And the brush I like to use is this one. It's just a little flimsy one. I think it is a very nice product. And it works nicely between a normal primer and foundation as well, if you want to. So you can layer it nicely. I think it is an amazing... I have a lot of Catrice stuff here, just so you know. I love me my Catrice. Let's go to foundations then. And let's... I have 3 foundations here. And 2 are my absolute favorites. The one that I'm going to mention now is actually last year's favorite. That is this one, the Maybelline Superstay. That I have on my face today. I still really love this foundation. And I have repurchased it multiple times. But it got dethroned when I... Well, got basically the next 2 that I'm going to talk about. So it's still one of my favorites, but it is not my absolute favorite anymore. I still wanted to mention it though, because yeah, again, I have it on my face today. Let's go to first my drugstore absolute favorite, which is kind of funny because I tried this one out last year and I did not really like it then. And I didn't understand the hype, but... I tried it again this year before I went to kind of declutter it or give it away. You know, I went through a lot of foundations then. I fell in love and I actually haven't stopped using it since almost. And that's the Catrice HD Liquid Coverage. I love this foundation so much. It is a thinner consistency. It is not full coverage because it's more of a medium coverage the way that I use it. You can build it up to full, but it is so pretty. It is like a second skin effect. And now that the weather is more cold and I am less sweaty, I don't usually need to powder this down. This now sets on itself for me. So I do have to say though, this oxidizes. About maybe a shade or half a shade. I don't really know how to... if it is a half a shade or a shade. I don't know, but it oxidizes. So if you see it, you think it's too light. But it kind of oxidizes on my face enough that it matches my neck. So if you think, oh, I don't have my exact shade. Try one that is lighter than your skin tone to see if it oxidizes for you. It does for me a tiny bit and I don't mind it, but I think it is very, very pretty. I think this is bottle number 3. Now we are actually getting to, yeah, my high-end favorite foundation. And that is the NARS Natural Radiant Longwear Foundation. The reason it looks like this is because this is my summer color. It is too dark for me now, unfortunately, because this is such a pretty foundation. Oh, and I so want to get my winter color, but it is so expensive. I got this as a present, by the way. It is just such a good foundation. And the only reason, again, I'm not using it now is because it is too dark for me. But yeah. This one gives a little bit more of a radiance, a little bit more of a luminous without making my face overly glittery and me looking like a disco ball. Because I don't like that. I don't like a dewy foundation. It just makes my face look oily. At least that's what I think. So yeah, those were my foundations. Let's go to concealer next. And there is only one concealer that I have used ever since it launched. I think it was beginning of this year. And that is the Catrice One Drop Coverage Concealer. This is this shade 010, a rosy ash, I believe. This is what I use now, and this color is sand beige, because I forgot to mention. My Maybelline is in ivory, my NARS summer color is in Valauris. So yeah, those were the colors, and this one from Catrice is just one color, there are no shades. This one I use now in winter. In summertime I used 030. But I have it here, which is a little bit more yellow, but I don't know the shade name, because it is here and it has rubbed off. And then kind of in between summer and winter, I mix the two together. This one is a little bit pinker. This one is a little bit more yellow. I also have one that's technically in between. That's the 020. That is too yellow. But it is such a fantastic product. Oh, you only need a drop. This is also with a dropper, so I just drop a little bit here, then I do this. One drop is enough to make a pretty big triangle. To be quite honest, I personally like to tap it in with my fingers and then maybe do the edges with a sponge. So usually I start here, so I tap here, then I go down, and then I go like that, and that is what I tap out to the outside. And in summertime, what I did when I didn't want a full face, I used this one on top of my sunscreen, obviously, this one. And then the extra coverage I did with this one. And this is 7 mils. I bought, this was the first bottle that I bought, and it is now kind of running on empty. Granted, I haven't used it in the height of summer because it was too light. So if you see that concealer in store, especially if you are a bit older, or you have dry under eyes, if you feel like your concealer makes you look cakey here, cakey and crappy, try this one. Yeah, and then let me know how it works out for you. I love the stuff. I wanted to say I'm done, but I'm not done, because I have my eye primers. So let's start with this one, which is the Catrice Eye Foundation. This was in my favorites last year as well, because I bought it last year. This is the matte. They also have a pearlescent one that I haven't tried yet. This is amazing stuff. I stopped using it for a while because I was trying out others. For instance, the MAC Paint Pot and the Smashbox one that I will mention in a little bit. The MAC Paint Pot is nice, but it's for me not worth all the hype, if I'm being quite honest. But yeah, maybe it is because my eyelids can be a little bit drier. So I do really like it during the summertime, when it is a little bit more warm. But that's only a short period of the year. So that is why it is not in this video, the MAC Paint Pot. Spoiler alert. Last year, I tested this one against the Smashbox Photo Finish, the clear one. This one is better. It is my favorite. Of what I have here, it is actually my favorite. I kind of strayed away from it a little bit, but now it's just a good one. The only downside is this one doesn't give you any coverage. So if you have a lot of staining, this will not cover it, basically. So yeah, let's go to the next one from Essence. This is the Color Intensifying Eyeshadow Base. This is very nice as well. This one has a little bit of a pinky tint to it, but also no coverage. Just saying. It does intensify your eyeshadow, as does the Catrice one. But again, this one has a little bit of a pink tint to it. That can sometimes be really, really pretty. So for instance, for pastels, this is a good one for me at least to use. This one dries down quicker, and is that a good term for it? It sets quicker. So if you don't like a tacky eyeshadow primer, you can try this one, because this one dries down on its own pretty quickly. So for me, because I like a tacky eyeshadow base, I need to work quickly with this. So I need to put it on, then wait maybe 30 seconds or something, and then apply my eyeshadow. If I wait longer than, I don't know, a minute, it has set already. So it's a very good one, especially for me, for difficult shadows that I don't really want to set. So I don't want to have a layer underneath, but I do want a layer underneath to blend on top of, you know. It's a nice eyeshadow. And cheap as chips. The last one that I'm going to mention, if I do need extra coverage, is the Smashbox Photo Finish Lid Primer in Light. And why do I mention this? Because it is actually not my favorite primer, because the other two are. But if I have staining and I need extra coverage, this is the one I grab. It is a very nice eyeshadow primer. However, I feel it is not worth the high price point. That is me. So yeah, while it is nice, it is not my absolute favorite, but this is my favorite to grab if I need more coverage. I hope that makes sense. It is my, yeah, I think that is it. Then the last product that I want to mention is my NYX Glitter Primer. This is very, very good. I did find, however, that it does not work underneath every shimmer, because sometimes, maybe it is me, maybe it is that I sometimes use too much and don't let it kind of set enough before I go in with a shimmer, because some shimmers looks like they want to break up, which is weird because they shouldn't. So yeah, there's that. So I think I have one shimmer that is notoriously breaking up on top of this one. I'm going to try it with this again and then kind of let it sit so it can dry down a bit more and then try it again. But yeah, I really, really like this primer underneath my shimmers. It helps keep them on longer because it sticks. The only thing I have to look out for, because my eyes are a little bit older, they are deep set, but you can maybe see here what is happening. It was a bit rainy outside and then this kind of happens. That's what I need to look out for. So if I put the glitter glue on top, I actually need to look down and do this and tap out creasing. And I also didn't tap out my creasing. I forgot this morning. So yeah, this is not the shadow's fault though. This is the fact that I didn't tap out the creasing of the NYX Glitter Primer and that it is raining outside. So yeah, I think that was it for my... Was that it for my primer stuff? Yes. That was it for my cream-based products. The next installment will be my powder product. So face powder, bronzer, blush, highlight and all that goodness. So guys, let me know down below what you thought of the products that I mentioned in today's video. Let me know your favorite cream-based products. Maybe there is something that I need to check out. And if you have tried any of the stuff that I mentioned today, let me know down below how you liked it. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, fabulous evening, and I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.